Sania's heart been Indian, it wouldn't have beaten for a Pakistani. Henceforth, Sania will not remain an Indian. If she wished to play for India, she should have chosen an Indian life partner, unquote. Now, Thackeray has also launched a bitter attack on Sania's fiancé, Shoaib Malik. Thackeray writes, and I quote, "We have heard that Shoaib has many affairs in India and has promised many girls he will marry them," unquote.
जो शोहर है शोएब, वो तो पाकिस्तान से खेलेगा हिंदुस्तान के खिलाफ, हिंदुस्तान को हराने के लिए वो पूरी जान से कोशिश करेगा, क्रिकेट के मैदान में हो या और किसी मैदान में हो। और दूसरी तरफ उनकी बीवी जो है सानिया, वो हमको रिप्रेजेंट करेगी। हिंदुस्तान का तमाशा बना है क्या? अब हिंदुस्तान को तमाशा बनाना चाहते हैं, ये नहीं चलेगा।
किसी तरह की टिप्पणी किसी की भी करना मुझे लगता है ठीक नहीं है, और फिर आप सामना में क्या लिखा है उस पर मुझे टिप्पणी करने की कोई आवश्यकता नहीं। जब मियाँ बीवी राजी तो क्या करेगा काजी। सानिया को सर्टिफिकेट देने के लिए कोई आवश्यकता नहीं, क्योंकि वो अच्छी खिलाड़ी है, सब लोग जानते हैं।
एक मुस्लिम रिलीजन की, मुस्लिम धर्म की है वो सानिया मिर्जा, उसको तो माँ बाप के बोलने पर शादी करना चाहिए थी, जहाँ शादी पहले लगी थी उस शादी को। लेकिन ये तो इश्क मोहब्बत करने वाले लोग हैं, माँ बाप का एहतराम नहीं है, कोई रिस्पेक्ट नहीं है। इन्होंने जाकर के वहाँ मोहब्बत वहाँ किया और शादी करने जा रही हैं। मुझे दुख है कि जिसके करोड़ों फैन हो वो जाकर के पाकिस्तान से शादी करके और दुबई में सेटल हो जाएं, तो मैं इसकी भरपूर निंदा करता हूँ, मुझे बिल्कुल पसंद नहीं है।
सनल इदामरुकूर, he's a rationalist, joining us live in our Noida studios. Malvika Sanghvi, you heard there Shiv Sena saying that this is not a normal wedding and Sania is clearly not a normal citizen. Now, Bal Thackeray has also said and slammed Sania Mirza for her decision to marry Shoaib Malik, saying that had Sania's heart been Indian, she wouldn't have decided to marry a Pakistani. Does heart really know any man-made boundaries?
No, hearts don't know any man-made boundary. But what I want to say is, for God's sake, leave these two people alone. She's a young girl about to get married. It's nobody's business. Everybody is using Sania and Shoaib as fair play, and everybody's getting a ride out of them. The media, because it wants to sell its newspapers and its airtime, the political parties, the governments of two countries. What have we forgotten? What humanity is about? I mean, can't we just leave them alone? And of course, hearts do. Sania's not the first girl who's going to get married to a foreigner. There are thousands before her. I suspect it's because she's Muslim. I mean, if she was a Hindu girl, even marrying a Pakistani, I don't think she would have been victimized to this extent.
You really think it's about being Hindu or Muslim that Sania is actually being victimized?
I think, yes. Yes, because in Sania's case, she has been at the receiving end of so much criticism, much more than any other sports person. And I think a lot of it has to do with her being Muslim and being seen as somebody who's fair game for everybody else. I hang my head in shame, really.
Ida Maruku, let me come to you now. India is clearly a democratic country and everyone has their own lives. Now, if Sania is entitled to marry someone of her own choice, is it fair to let Bal Thackeray have his own choice and his own views as far as the wedding is concerned?
I think the marriage of any individual of the country, or in that matter, if somebody likes a person or love a person, or how to live and how to go ahead with their life, it's absolutely their personal discretion. Okay. In my personal opinion, all the boundaries, the national boundaries, the religious boundaries, the caste boundaries, everything should be absolutely neglected when human hearts come together. Human hearts are more important. Let it come together whenever it's wanted.
Right, but you heard Ms. Sanghvi there saying that it is actually about her being a Muslim and she's being victimized. Do you agree with her point of view?
No, my feeling primarily is that, you know, there's a lot of hatred for Pakistan because of so many political reasons. But when it comes to individual liking for another person, and yes, we should shed away these kind of things, you know, because these boundaries, these quarrels, all these kind of things are human-made.
Right.
Ultimately, individuals should decide what they want.
Waker here, Martin R. Waker, though Sania Mirza has said she would retain her Indian passport, also play for India, despite settling in Dubai after her wedding. Your party says it can't tolerate this. Why is that? After all, she's an individual, has also earned India a lot of pride.
Of course, if she's an Indian citizen, she has the right to retain her citizenship. But if you see the precedents of the past where celebrities have got, or individuals have got married to people of other nationality, especially Pakistani nationality, more often than not, they are made to or change their nationality because of domestic pressure, and rightly so. If we were to get some other national into our country, and we would naturally expect that national to take up our citizenship if that individual is staying in our country and enjoying all the benefits and deriving all the benefits from our country. So at the end of the day, if that happens, hypothetically happens, then naturally it wouldn't be fair to India as well.
Mr. Edamaruk, let me come to you. Like I was asking Ms. Sanghvi, the Pakistan High Commission denied Sania a visa to Sialkot. We know that that's the hometown of Shoaib Malik. If Pakistan is reluctant to welcome Sania Mirza into their country, why are we so overwhelmed?
No, I think the fundamental question is very simple, that two persons are deciding to be together. And whatever is the whole society or country is speaking about that thing, is not a business of ours. But if Pakistan government is stopping her coming there, and they have to find some ways to stop that thing. But even if after marrying a Pakistan citizen, there is enough reasons for her to play for India also. She has full freedom to do that thing. She can retain her Indian citizenship also if she wants. But all the same, we have to see that we cannot hold a person by force. If we give proper respect for her, I hope she would remain in India.
Right.
As an Indian citizen, maybe she's married to a Pakistani, but she will play for India. That's what I hope.
There is also a ground of morality involved in this. Please look at the antecedents of this person. It's proved beyond doubt that this person has got married to another Indian citizen. And now, at the drop of the hat, he's willing to ditch her and get married to someone else. Isn't that a cause of concern? On one hand, we've got Sania Mirza working on a campaign to protect the girl child, to promote the interests of women. And
like
on the other hand,
like
we find her in
that.
A position where Ms. Sanghvi, she is actually working to the detriment of the interest of another
I'd
girl.
Like to come in on that, please. There is a very well-known actress, a leading member of the BJP, who is the second wife of a very well-known actor. What does the BJP have to say about that? Why do they give her Rajya Sabha membership or Lok Sabha membership? I mean, why do they nominate people like that to
represent their cadre? But anyway, the point that Shiv Sena just...
The Shiv Sena is a partner of the BJP.
Go ahead, make your point.
One more important point is that, you know, this is not a question of India and Pakistan having marriage. When Indians themselves marry with different religions, for example, when a Hindu marriage happens with a Muslim in India, what kind of social repression happens on that thing?
Right.
What kind of honor killings are happening in this country when castes are marrying? We have a lot of prejudices against human decision.
And what Mr. Navlekar was saying, actually, I'm sure that even her parents would have done the background check, considering that they're marrying.
It's the individual who decides. Ultimately, it's the individual that's the basic unit. It's the freedom of the...
Okay.
So there are all kinds of prejudices, all types of awful hostilities and aggressions and hatred coming up. I mean, yes, it's a blow to the male libido also. a lot of Indian men have taken this very badly, and I think of course it is a blow to their libido, such as it may be.
Okay, Mr. Edamaruk, do you agree with that? A blow to male libido?
I support this marriage, absolutely, because I believe that all these boundaries of caste, religion, all everything should ultimately go.
Like Ms. Sanghvi is actually saying that it's actually about Indian men feeling really bad that Sania had to go across the border to find someone.
I understand that. I would prefer that much more Indians should marry across the borders from Pakistan and Bangladesh and Iran and Europe and everywhere. Let there be a universal man emerging. Let the boundaries go away and let there be cosmopolitanism, I mean, which makes man and woman as the ultimate, basically.
Well, it's a wrap in this show, Match Fixing Controversy. For all the news and updates, you just need to log on to newsx.com. Thanks for watching.